Through my entire adult life, from the point that I reached probably 22, 23 years old, I always had issues going on digestively. I never was sure what they were. I would go to the doctor, but I never was diagnosed with Crohn's disease until about 11 years ago.
The first time I remember him suffering from Crohn's was when I got a little bit older. I think as parents, they don't tell their children you're sick.
One of my really good friends growing up, she was diagnosed with Crohn's, so I was a little familiar with the disease.
In my entire life, I've always loved cars. And I'm sure that's not a, you know, an uncommon story to most men, but I've always loved cars, any kind of cars. When I was a young child, I thought, if only one day I can own a Lamborghini. So I was fortunate enough to actually own two Lamborghinis, but what I found, my disease actually limited me being able to enjoy those cars. Are there bathrooms along the way? If I get out, you know, too far away from a bathroom, you know, is that going to end, you know, with a bad situation?
As a family, like, we like to go out and eat, so it's just, you have to remember only certain places and only certain times because you have to take in consideration what he's going through.
So it really became something where I became almost like a hermit. I would go to work, I would do the things I needed to do and the things that I had to do, but I quit doing the things that I love to do. And it really came down to just the limitations that the disease put in my daily life. 5.5 years ago, I ended up with a pretty severe case of a flare-up. I'd went to the hospital that afternoon. Didn't know, I thought maybe I was just run down, dehydrated. The next thing I know, they're preparing me for ambulance transport up to Chapel Hill.
I met Ken in the hospital. That's not a great place to meet someone, obviously. Ken had been struggling to such an extent with symptoms that he really couldn't do it anymore.
I had taken a lot of medications through the years. None really worked well, maybe one or two, but not even those were not long-term solutions.
We needed to think outside of the umbrella of standard therapies. He had actually had side effects to those standard therapies. The best option for him, in my mind, was considering a clinical trial. One of the things I was impressed by for Ken is his willingness to hear all options. Sometimes people will hear the word clinical trial and have an immediate negative response to it.
Through the last 5-6 years, I've been involved in multiple clinical trials. Some had no effect at all, some helped slightly, but at the end of the day, I knew it wasn't a solution that would work for me long term. The clinical trials were different in length. Some were 6 months, some were a year. Some were canceled after getting a couple months into the trial. Each time I would do a clinical trial and there was little to no relief from it, it would get somewhat discouraging, but I can really say that Dr. Long and her staff would take it and keep pushing. Okay, this one didn't work for you, but the next one, it's promising. We've had patients that did have good reaction to it, so let's try something different, and we kept pushing ahead. We started to go down the path of a different study that, again, we had hopes that it would work for me. If I had questions, if there were things that I didn't understand, things I was concerned about, they were that focal point for information back to me and the communication back to the doctor. They were always there, always, you know, literally just a phone call away, an email away, to provide whatever support that I needed. I really could tell within the first 3 or 4 weeks that things were starting to get better. The number of frequency that I had to go to the restroom was starting to drop. I had less pain. I had less tiredness every day. I just felt better in general.
I remember him saying to me one day, it was probably a couple of months after he first started the clinical trial. He said, you know, I feel really good today. And he said, and it's been a long time since I felt really, really good. So to me, I think that was just the beginning of the turning point for him.
I remember meeting with Dr. Long saying, you know, I really think this is working.
I feel like his health has improved greatly. I mean, I can just see it on his face that, you know, he's enjoying life more. We don't have to stop as much. When we're working on cars, we can work longer hours. We can drive farther distances.
Now that I'm in remission, things are going much better. We now take the latest Lamborghini we have, and we take it out all the time. It's about an every week or maybe 2 weeks at the most enjoyment for us. We'll take that out, we'll travel, we'll just ride around, and it's become something that I enjoy doing again.
By someone participating in a clinical trial, they not only could potentially have benefit for themselves, but for countless other individuals. Where he was one of six people here at UNC who participated in the trial, those six people joined about 600 other people across the country in participation in this trial. Because of their participation, this therapy has now been approved for the treatment of Crohn's disease. About 1% of the population of the United States that will now have access to that therapy. So by Ken's participation, we're looking at thousands-fold ability for that drug to impact other patients.
If there's one thing I could add to any of this, it was for me in the beginning to be somewhat scared about what clinical trials are. You don't understand them. You don't know what's ahead. If you're at a point in your disease that you've tried other options and these are the things that can bring you relief, don't let the fear be something that drives you away from, from health and happiness.